In this lesson, we will model the product of a whole number and a fraction using fraction bars. Looking at the table below, in the first column we have the product involving a whole number and a fraction. In the second column, we will draw a model of the product. In the third column, we'll write a multiplication sentence or multiplication equation from the model. Looking at the first product, we have 3 times 1/4. 3 times 1/4 means 3 copies of 1/4. So to model 3 times 1/4 or 3 copies of 1/4, we'll begin by modeling 1/4. So if we let 1 bar equal 1 whole or 1 unit, because the denominator is 4, we would cut the bar into 4 equal sized pieces or parts, and then because the numerator is 1, we would shade one of the 4 parts or pieces. So this is a model for the fraction 1/4. To model 3 times 1/4 or 3 copies of 1/4, we need 3 of these models. So here's the model for 3 copies of 1/4. Notice altogether we have a total of 1, 2, 3 copies of 1/4, which means 3 times 1/4 equals 3/4, which is our multiplication sentence or multiplication equation. And now let's look at the second example that's a little bit more involved. The product is 4 times 3/5, which means 4 copies of 3/5. To begin to model 4 copies of 3/5, we'll first model the fraction 3/5. So to do this, we'll cut 1 bar into 5 equal sized pieces of parts, and because the numerator is 3, we shade 3 of them. So this is the model for 3/5, or 1 copy of 3/5. And therefore, to model 4 times 3/5, or 4 copies of 3/5, we need 4 of these models. So here are 4 copies of 3/5, which represents the product. And now let's determine the total amount. We'll do this by determining the total number of copies of 1/5. Notice each model of 3/5 contains 3 copies of 1/5. So there's a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 copies of 1/5, which means 4 times 3/5 is equal to 12/5. But there's also another way to write this product. Remember, because the denominator is 5, it takes 5 parts or pieces to make 1 whole, or we can say it takes 5 copies of 1/5 to make 1 whole. So let's also write this product as a mixed number. Going back over to our model, let's renumber the copies of 1/5. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 copies of 1/5. So this amount is equal to 1 whole. And let's begin counting again. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 copies of 1/5. 5 copies of 1/5 is equal to 1. So notice now we have a total of 2, and we still have 2 copies of 1/5. So notice how the value is also 2 2/5. So let's write the product as 4 times 3/5 equals 2 2/5. Both products are correct. I hope you found this helpful.